sharing my faith and helping others share their faith, I think, is one of the richest experiences of the Christian life. And it's something that has helped me grow more than anything else. I remember sitting on a curb in Brooklyn, and these two gang members were sitting outside the school. They had been expelled from the school. And they were waiting for their friends to be dismissed from class. And I began to talk to them. One was called House. He was really big, and his buddy was real skinny. His name was Ghost. That were their gang names. And as I began to share with them, tears began to run down their eyes as I talked to them about the love of Christ. And I remember Ghost saying to me, "You have no idea. You have no idea what I go through." And I said, "Well, tell me about your family." And he said, "I have no family." And then his gang members had gathered around behind him. And he said, "You want to see my family? Look behind you." And I looked behind me, and all these gang members had gathered behind us. And they all lined up, and they listened to what I had to say. There must have been about 10 or 12 of them. Where we were talking about life and death, they would just lock in. And these are some of the hardcore kids from the streets of New York. And I asked each one of them, "Would you like to trust Christ today?" And they all would look at Ghost and House and wonder what were they going to say, because some of these guys wanted to receive Christ so badly. And I know Ghost wanted to give his life to Christ. I know that the gospel touched him. And you know, when Paul said, "For I'm not ashamed of the gospel, because it has the power to change lives," I saw the gospel work in his life that day. But when I asked Ghost, "Would you like to trust Christ today?" he hung his head and reluctantly said no. And so they all nodded their heads, "No, not today, not today. We have unfinished business." So we left that day, and we were saddened that Ghost and his friend House and all his other gang members all said no, "We're not ready to receive Christ today." And my thought was, if someone could come back here. But whether someone came back or not, I know that God used that, because what I've learned about evangelism over the years is that I am just one person in a process in someone's life. And there's very few people where I get to see the beginning of sharing the gospel and then them coming to Christ. I mean, it happens, but usually I'm just one person in the process. Sometimes I get to be the person who leads them to Christ. Sometimes I'm the person who first introduces them to the gospel. Sometimes I'm in the middle somewhere. And so my prayer that day was, "Lord, send somebody into the life of House. Send somebody into the life of Ghost." Because these are kids, and they were just 16, 17-year-old boys. These are kids who you created, who you love. They have a hard life. They don't know who their family is. They may be living on the street, but you loved them. You died for them. And so I was confident that God would take what I used and use that in his process. And when I begin to think that I'm responsible for every aspect of someone coming to Christ, then I'm robbing from Christ what he's really doing and trying to take it upon myself. We need to share Christ with every opportunity we have and trust the Holy Spirit to do the follow-up that's needed and the work in their lives. Kids all over this nation are open to Christ. It doesn't matter if they're hardcore kids on the street, if they're kids who grew up in a farm like myself. There's kids asking questions that no one is answering for them. And I find this, that if I'm kind, if I'm respectful, if I ask a lot of questions and show interest, that I can talk to almost anybody about Christ. And when we come with a spiritual solution to their problems, kids are responding. And so I just highly encourage people, share your faith, learn how to share your faith, because it's going to be the richest experience of your Christian life.